गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ शांति। आई एम गोइंग टू डू डिजिटल कम्युनिकेशन सब्जेक्ट। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज कोडिंग ऑफ पीसीएम सिग्नल्स एंड डीकोडिंग ऑफ पीसीएम सिग्नल्स। सी एक्चुअली व्हाट इज मीन बाय पीसीएम इज पल्स कोड मॉड्यूलेशन, राइट? द सिग्नल इज पल्स कोड मॉड्यूलेटेड टू कन्वर्ट इट्स एनालॉग इन्फॉर्मेशन इनटू बाइनरी सीक्वेंस, दैट इज वन्स एंड जीरोस। सो जनरली व्हेन एवर यू आर गोइंग फॉर पीसीएम, in PCM the message signal is represented by a sequence of coded pulses. This message signal is achieved by representing the signal in discrete form in both the time and amplitude. So generally what is meant by coding in PCM is it is a method used to digitally represent sampled analog signals. So in a PCM stream, amplitude of the analog signal is sampled regularly at uniform intervals, and each sample whatever we are getting. So the main function of PCM, pulse code modulation, is it will convert the analog signals into digital signals. So how it converts? In order to convert, it requires three processes to be done. Those are sampling, quantizing and encoding, we call it as. So pulse code modulation is a method used to digitally represent sampled analog signals. In a PCM stream, amplitude of the analog signal is sampled regularly at uniform intervals, and each sample is quantized to the nearest value with a range of digital steps. So whenever we are going for PCM, the first thing whatever it takes place is sampling. So sampling means it will divide the continuous signals into discrete pulses, or it makes samples, we call it as. So coding of PCM and decoding of PCM signal. So what do you mean by coding of PCM? So PCM coding means digitally representing the sample analog signal. Decoding means again converting that sample signal into analog signal, continuous signal. So that is nothing but coding and decoding we call this. Generally coding will be done at the transmitter part, decoding will be done at the receiver part. Already we are aware that whenever we are taking a transmitter part and at a receiver part, the transmitter part, what happens is modulation will be done. So at here encoding will be done, whereas at a receiver part demodulation will be done and decoding will be done. See, what is coding of PCM signals? It is a process of converting an analog signal into PCM signal. It is called coding, we call it as. So when we are converting analog signal into digital signal, the transmitter part, it is coding, called as coding. And at a receiver part, this coded signal is again decoded, that is the PCM signal whatever we had obtained, that is a digital signal, has to be converted into analog signal, is called decoding, we call it as. So it is a process of converting analog signal into PCM signal is called decoding. The process of converting a digital signal into analog signal is called decoding, we call it as. The coding and decoding can be obtained by using a single integrated circuit called codec, we call it as. Okay, the term codec is a combination of coder and decoder. Okay, now generally what is the principle of PCM is, it involves important principles such as sampling, quantizing, encoding, pulse shaping and decoding. The signal is merely a sequence of on-off pulses or marks and space, we call it as. But the pulse amplitude, pulse width and pulse position does not vary. So codec is a combination of coder and decoder, a device or a single integrated circuit which has the capability of coding and decoding is called codec, we call it as. Now coding in PCM signals, analog signal, how coding will be done is, analog message signal is given to low pass filter. The function of low pass filter is, it acts as an anti-aliasing filter. So sample signal whatever we are taking, coding of PCM signal consists of a continuous signal, analog message signal given to low pass filter. It this low pass filter is anti-aliasing filter, we call it as anti-aliasing low pass filter specifies that it follows the Nyquist criteria, that is fs greater than or equal to 2 times of fm will be followed, and that output is given to sampler. The function of sampler is whatever the output that you are getting from the low pass filter is given to sampler, where this continuous signal is slotted into samples. The sample signal is given to quantizer. Quantizer function is maintains the voltage levels of the sample signals, and that is given to encoder. Encoder may gives that quantized signal as binary data, and that is given to parallel to serial converters. The first stage is a higher order low pass filter to prevent distortion due to aliasing or foldover distortion results. The filter should be capable of blocking all the frequency components above one half of the sampling frequency. So whenever you are going for whenever we are going for low pass filter, the first stage is a higher order low pass filter to prevent distortion due to aliasing or foldover distortion, we call it as. The filter should be capable of blocking all the frequency components above one half. So here, when you are going for pulse code modulation coding will be done, which makes it sample analog signal. The method distortion will prevent the sample analog signal. So the first stage in this pulse code modulation is low pass filter. So prior to that, we have to know that pulse code modulation is a method used to digitally sample the signals. It is standard form of digital audio in computers, compact discs, digital telephone and other digital audio applications. So we will use this pulse code modulation. In a PCM stream, amplitude of the analog signal is sampled regularly at uniform intervals, and each sample is quantized to a nearest value with a range of digital steps. So linear pulse code modulation is a specific type of PCM in which quantization levels are linearly uniform. So whatever you are doing through PCM is a more generally often used to describe data encoded as LPCM, that is linear pulse code modulation we call it as. PCM has two basic properties that determine the streams to original log signal, that is sampling rate, which is number of times per second that samples are taken. So which determines the possible digital values, we call it as. So whenever you are going for PCM, standard PCM rates and how it has been taking place, generally we'll have different types of implementations for modulation and demodulation of the information. Okay, here low pass filter, the process of coding of a PCM, what it will do is some forms of PCMs combine signal processing with coding. Okay, so here what we will do, we have different types of PCMs like linear PCM, differential PCM, adaptive PCM. In that we will have different types of PCM techniques. There coding and decoding will be done based on coding and decoding of this PCM signal will be done based on the information. The function of low pass filter. So what is the function of low pass filter is? So here you have low pass filter, sampler, quantizer, encoder and parallel to serial converter. That will be at a transmitter part. At a transmitter part, what we are doing is to get a pulse code modulated waveform from an analog waveform at a transmitter end of a communication circuit. Amplitude of the analog signal samples at regular intervals. The sampling rate or the number of samples per second is several times the maximum frequency. The message signal converted into the binary form will be usually in the number of levels, which is always to the powers of 2. This process is called quantization, we call it as. At the receiver end, a pulse code demodulator decodes the binary signal back into the pulses. with the same quantum levels as those in the modulator. We can restore the original analog waveform. So at the transmitter part, whatever you have, a source of continuous time message signal, and that is fed to low pass filter, sampler, quantizer, encoder, PCM signal applied to channel input. At a receiver part, final channel output is taken up and is given to regeneration circuit. From there it is given to decoder, reconstruction filter, then destination. So in between the transmitter and receiver, you will have a channel or a transmission path, we call it as. That is, the PCM signal produced at the output of the transmitter is given to regenerative repeaters, and it is given to regenerated PCM signal that is applied at the receiver end. So already we had discussed about sampler, quantization and encoding. Now let us discuss what are the different blocks that are present in the coding of PCM signals. The first signal is low pass filter. So this is used to remove the high frequency components that are present within the input signal and analog signal. Okay. Here this signal is higher as compared to the highest frequency message signal, so that it avoids aliasing of the message signal. So what is meant by aliasing effect? Aliasing effect is a condition whenever you had gone through sampling theorem, it will follow Nyquist criteria. So if fs greater than or equal to 2 times of fm, this condition specifies that we are generating the data, that is at a receiver end, reconstruction of the signal will be done with minimum amount of distortion. But when a condition is fs less than 2 times of fm, this condition is known as aliasing, we call it as. So this aliasing effect of follow-over distortion, if this is present, original signal cannot be detected exactly at the receiver part. So in order to avoid that, we are using anti-aliasing low-pass filters. This low-pass filter is used to remove the high-frequency components that are present within the input analog signal. Here, this signal is higher as compared to the highest frequency message signal, so that it avoids aliasing of the message signals. Then you have about the filter should be capable of blocking all the frequency components above 1/2. Next block in the session is sampler. So sampler specifies the next step in the generation of PCM is to sample the incoming message signal using a sample and hold circuit. Already we had discussed about sample and hold circuit. So the function of sample and hold circuit is, the purpose of this sample and hold circuit is to store the instantaneous value of the sample signal for a small duration to produce a flat top sample output. So what is meant by flat top sample? So generally whenever you are going for sampling, you will have two types of sampling techniques will be there, that is flat top sampling and natural sampling, we call it as. So flat top sampling and natural sampling, there is a difference between them. So generally flat top sampling means during transmission, noise is introduced at the top of the transmission pulse, which can be easily removed if the pulse is in the form of flat top. So generally what happens is, flat top sample specifies that natural sampling, whenever you are taking, there if a waveform is represented, so flat, generally you will get in this way. So what a flat top sample will do, noise will be more at a transmission path, at the transmitting end. So if we cut this and if you make it flat, it is termed as flat top sample. So noise can be reduced. So during transmission, noise is introduced at the top of a transmission pulse, which can be easily removed if the pulse is in the form of flat top. Here the top of the samples are flat, that is they have constant amplitude, hence it is known as flat top sampling or practical sampling, we call it as. So the purpose of sample and hold circuit is to store the instantaneous value of the sample signal for a small duration to produce a flat top sample output. In order to get a perfect reconstruction of the message signal at the receiver, sampling rate must be greater than the highest frequency component of the message signal. That is, in order to get a perfect reconstruction of the filter, already we know that fs should be
for FS greater than or equal to times FM, that is, it should follow the Nyquist criteria. Then you have different types of samplings, flat top sampling and the natural sampling. For the generation of PM signal, we use flat top type PM scheme, because during the transmission, noise is interfered at the top of the transmission pulse, which can be easily removed if the PM is flat top. Natural top scheme, taking natural top, there is no possibility of making that noise eradicated using natural sampling. Then the next block which you have is quantizer, we call it as. So what is the function of quantizer is, whatever the sampled signal you are taking. So when you are taking a sampled signal, quantization is a process. Generally what happens is, the amplitude of the analog signal is sampled at uniform intervals, and each sample is quantized to its nearest value with a predetermined range of digital signal levels. So quantization is a process. Generally it is used in digital modulation techniques, digital signal processing. It is a process of mapping the input values from the largest set, often continuous set, to output values, that is countable. That is, an analog to digital converter is an example of quantizer, we call it as. So quantization is a technique where generally quantization is process of assigning the voltage levels. Original analog signal can have infinite number of signal levels. If we use quantization, it assigns samples to any of the samples which is closest to the quantization level. So quantizer is the number of levels available, depends upon the number of bits used to express the sample values. The number of levels is given by n is equal to 2 power m, where n is the number of levels, m is the number of bits per sample. Quantization process will produce errors called quantization error, or Q noise we call it as. So in digital filters, quantization errors can be classified as round of errors derived from internal signals that are quantized before or after more deviations in the filter response due to finite word length representation of multiplier coefficients. So what is meant by quantization, quantizing error are, so generally whenever you are going for quantization, there exists, there will be error that occurs in the quantization process. It is termed as quantization error or Q noise. So if you see on the screen, these are the quantization levels, these are the quantizing levels. So quantizing level specifies that it is maintaining the data. Figure shows how quantization error occurs. The largest possible error is 1/2 of the difference between the levels. The levels of quantization noise can be decreased by increasing the number of levels, but increasing the number of levels requires more bits per sample. In order to increase the number of levels, it requires more bits per sample. So for that we are going for dynamic range of PCM, is the ratio of strongest possible combination signal to that of the weakest signal, weakest possible signal. So when you are taking the information, you are calculating in that way that the number of levels are equal to 2 power bits. Just I am giving an example. This is a B is a bits, L is the number of levels, we call it as. So based on the number of bits, if the number of bits are 2, the number of levels are 4. If the number of bits are 3, the number of levels are 8. In that way, we will maintain the levels based on the bits. So what is the function of encoder is, encoder in PCM encodes the quantized signal values. So what it will do is, it will check the quantized signal output. Okay, it used encoded data in the serial digital format and transmit it on the carrier to another location for decoding and analysis.
PCM systems are less susceptible to noise than analog signal, and digital data is easier to transmit, record, and analyze. So encoding is a process in which the sample voltages are converted into digital equivalent, analog to digital converter performs it. Now if you are taking 256 quantization levels coded by 8 bits, analog sample voltage A to D converter, D7, D6 to D0. So 256 levels can be quantized. In the screen we had given you analog to digital converter, we are having 256 quantization levels for coded up 8 bits. Already we are aware that whenever you are taking this number of levels can be given by 2 power bits. If the number of bits are 8, L is equal to 2 power 8, which will give you 256 quantization levels. Now after the quantization, we are having, that is PCM encoding, we are having parallel to serial converter. So sampler, quantizer, encoder, and then parallel to serial converter. So in this parallel to serial converter, output of the ADC is in parallel form. It is, if that is to be directly transmitted, we need 8 wires from transmitter to receiver. So as we had seen that we are having 256, the number of levels are 256, 8 bits are there, so 8 wires are needed from transmitter to receiver. To save the transmission media, the bits in parallel form are converted into serial form and serial data is applied to a channel. So what happens is, if at all you are using if you are using serial converter, it is generally, if you use a parallel, you have to use 8 wires. Instead of that, you can convert into serial. So if the output of the ADC is in the parallel form, if that is to be directly transmitted, we need 8 wires from the transmitter to receiver. To save the transmission media, bits is in the parallel form are converted to serial form. And serial data is applied to the channel. Shift registers operated in parallel to serial mode will act as parallel to serial converter. Parallel to serial converter, we call it as. So now, what is the decoding of PCM signal? Under decoding of PCM signal, you are having serial to parallel converter, decoder or DTA converter, reconstruction filter. So here what we are doing is, whatever the output that are generated from the transmitter part is given to regenerative repeaters, and from there it is given to decoder circuit. So in the PCM decoder module, there is a circuitry which automatically identifies the location of each frame in the serial data system. To do this, it collects group of 8 data bits or looks for the repeating pattern of alternate 1s and zeros placed there, embedded by the PCM encoder in the LSB position. So PCM decoding, in PCM decoding, so generally it is driven by an external clock pulse will be taken up. Here what we will do is, serial to parallel converter will be used now to convert the serial information into parallel form, and then that is given to decoder output of the encoder. Decoder output from the converter. So what it will do is, digital to analog conversion will be done, and then you are using reconstructive low pass filters. So whatever the data that has to be transmitted, the effects of compression and expansion on weak and strong signals can be investigated also. So here always remember that whenever you are taking information, you are having serial to parallel converter, then decoder. Decoder is a function, so all the way that has been done in the PCM is encoding and decoding. Decoding will, that is encoding and decoding. So here serial to parallel converter is used, and then decoder DTA converter is used. From there it is going to reconstructive low pass filter. Reconstructive low pass filter specifies anti-aliasing low pass filter. Reconstructive low pass filter produces urgent signal. So serial to parallel converter, the receiver bits are in the serial form, hence it is converted into parallel form using serial to parallel converter before applying to digital to analog converter. Shift registers operated in serial to parallel mode will act as serial to parallel converters. So what is used as a serial to parallel converter is shift registers are used. So what is the function of shift registers? So we have to know what is the function of shift registers in PCM. So shift registers, input is an n-bit parallel binary signal. Output of the stream of n-bits transmitted one after another sequentially. The stream is transmitted over a cable, wireless or fiber optic link. From the transmitted signal, the original wave can be recreated or recollected with computers. So generally, what a shift register will do is, shift register is a type of digital circuit using a cascade of flip-flops where the output of one flip-flop is connected to input of the next flip-flop. They share a single clock signal which causes the data stored in the system to shift from one location to the next location. So serial to parallel converter, the receiver bits are in the serial form, hence it is to be converted into parallel form using serial to parallel converter before applying to DAC. Shift registers operated in serial to parallel mode will act as serial to parallel converter. Now decoding. Decoding of the PCM signal will be done. That is, digital to analog conversion will be done at this. It acts as a digital to analog converter. Parallel bits are applied to DAC to get the analog equivalent of the input data. So DAC, what makes a difference between digital to analog converter and analog to digital converter? As a transmitter part, whatever we are doing, we are converting the digital signal into analog form. At a receiver part, we are taking digital signal in the parallel bits are applied to DAC to get the analog equivalent of the input data. Reconstruction filter. So how you reconstruct the filter is, reconstruction filter in PCM. So what is the function of reconstruction filter is, it is also termed as anti-imaging filter, we call it as. So what type of filter is a reconstruction filter is, so generally whatever the data that has to be in order to obtain, reconstruction filter specifies that for smooth filter and an anti-imaging filter will be termed as reconstruction filter, we call it as. So whenever you are going for reconstruction filter with respect to PCM, so what it will do is, final operation of the decoding of PCM. Final operation in the decoding of PCM signal is to recover the message signal by passing the output of DAC sample voltage to a low pass reconstruction filter. So reconstruction filter in receiver of a PCM signal. So what it will do, what is the function of reconstruction filter in PCM is, reconstruction filter in PCM. So what it will do is, records original message signal by passing it through low output of DAC. So low pass reconstruction filter, we call it as. This filter eliminates the high frequency components present in the signal and allows only low frequency signals to pass through it. So how a decoding will be done is,
using this cutoff frequency is equal to the message signal bandwidth. Output of the reconstruction filter is the reconstruction of message signal, we call it as. Then what are the advantages of PCM and what are the disadvantages? Until and unless now, whatever we had learned is encoding and decoding of PCM. Under encoding of PCM, we are using sampleizer font, that is sampling, fontization, encoding, parallel to serial converter. So that is used as a transmitter part. Once I am showing you the block diagram. This is the block diagram which consists of the low pass filter, sampler, quantizer, encoder, parallel to serial converter. The output is given to digital to serial or PCM output. Here analog to analog message signal. See what are advantages of PCM: ruggedness of transmission, noise interference and noise interference, efficient regeneration of coded signals along the transmission medium, the possibility of uniform format for different types of message signals, ease of multiplexing. So what are advantages of PCM are, whenever we have gone through the advantages, so ruggedness to transmission. So advantage of PCM is generally constant signal to noise ratio is maintained by digitizing the signal. Multiple use of one transmission channel by multiplexing technique. Interference free signal transmission, low susceptibility to crosstalk, direct acquisition and processing of the received signal. So ruggedness to transmission, noise and interference. So what it specifies is noise will be less, interference will be less using PCM. Efficient regeneration of coded signals along the transmission path. Possibility of uniform format for different types of message signals. Ease of multiplexing. These are advantages of PCM. Then what are the disadvantages of PCM? The disadvantages of PCM is large bandwidth, synchronization between transmitter and receiver is required. So synchronization, what is mean by synchronization is so synchronization specifies that clock pulses has to be met both the transmitter and receiver. So what is the importance of synchronization in PCM is bit synchronization is required in PCM. Okay, what it will do is it will maintain the data that has to be delivered exactly. So here generally synchronization between a transmitter and receiver is required. This depends upon the data link layer, physical layer, network layer, session layer, application layer that are present in the digital communication. That is data communication and computer networks. We will learn about the synchronization standards. So synchronization is required. So here bit synchronization is required. So bit synchronization is required because whatever the data that we are transmitting, it will have a terminating equipment, terminal equipment will be there, and circuit terminating equipment will be there. Based on that, we are generating a bit which depends upon the clock signal or clock pulse. So bit synchronous operation is sometimes referred to as digital synchronization also. So this synchronization is required for transmitter and receiver signal that is present in the PCM signals. So what is the synchronization? So what is the disadvantage of this PCM is large bandwidth is required. So large bandwidth means what? So based on the number of bits that have been transmitted, it depends upon the bandwidth. So how much bandwidth will be taken up in PCM is requires a transmission of bit stream using creation of 2 bits per cycle to have signal frequency. When transmitting a 3-bit coded pulses, we are using the generally the disadvantage of PCM is larger bandwidth.
we can say this is bandwidth of the PCM signal depends upon the bit rate and the pulse shape. For no aliasing, that is the Nyquist criteria, fs greater than or equal to 2 times of fm, or fs is equal to 2 times of fm is specified. Fm is the message signal frequency. The bandwidth of PCM signal is greater than the bandwidth of the analog signal, we call it as. So we can calculate the PCM, we can calculate the bandwidth of PCM based on the signal generated. That is, you will take the rectangular pulse that has been generated using the duration. So several ways will be there to measure the bandwidth. Okay, so minimum Nyquist criteria has to be maintained, that is fs should be greater than or equal to 2 times of fm. So if you are taking the bandwidth of the PCM is large. Apart from that, the disadvantage is synchronization is required between a transmitter and receiver. So synchronization between transmitter and receiver specifies that if synchronization is required, it also specifies that what it is, the cost will be more. Okay, so generally what is meant by synchronization is it is a coordination of information to operate. That is, whatever we are taking, synchronization specifies that all the information that has to be transmitted at the clock pulses has to be maintained. So based on the clock pulses, the data will be delivered. Here what we will do is synchronization of the receiver or synchronization of the transmitter will have in the PCM is telemetry system, we call it as. So what we will do is we will maintain a constant clock pulses at both the transmitter and receiver. So what it will do, whatever the data we are transmitting, it will maintain the clock pulses. So that is nothing but bit length, the capability of the bits that has to be generated is maintained. Okay, so this is the importance of synchronization. Bit synchronization is required. So it is the most important technique in the digital communication system, which will determine the performance of the system. The performance of the entire system will be given by this synchronization technique. So generally, in order to encode and decode the data, you are using this synchronization techniques. So once again, I am repeating, generally we have coding of PCM signal and a decoding of PCM signal. Under the coding of PCM signals, you are having analog message signal that is given to low pass filter. This low pass filter is also termed as anti-aliasing low pass filter, we call it as. The output of anti-aliasing low pass filter is given to sampler and quantizer. Sampler, it samples the incoming analog signal and that is fed to quantizer. The function of quantizer is whatever the sample signal that has been obtained, it will be maintaining a predetermined voltage levels that will be given by quantizer. Quantizing or quantization technique is assigning the voltage levels to the sample signals. So that is given to encoder. The voltage level that has been assigned are converted into binary signals, binary pulses using encoder. The output of the encoder is given to parallel to serial converter, so which produces digital serial PCM output. So why you are converting parallel to serial converter is in order to cost effective, in order to maintain cost effective. If you are maintaining parallel, it requires, if you are using 2 bits, it requires 2 parallel watts. If you are using 8 bits, it requires 8 parallel watts. So instead of that, if you maintain a serial, you can get the same data using a serial single wire, that is termed as parallel to serial converter, we call it as. This is a PCM coding process. After coding process in the transmitter, it is given to a transmission path that is regenerated with repeaters will be there, channel which is given to decoder form. At a decoder form, what it will do is PCM input from the serial data is again at a receiver part, that serial has to be converted into parallel form. That is, serial to parallel converters will be used. From there, the data is given to decoder or D2A converter, we call it as. That D2A converter output is again given to reconstruction filter, that is reconstruction low pass filters, we call it as. So the function of reconstruction filters in PCM is in order to maintain the anti-aliased information that has to be given.
So this anti-aliasing or reconstruction filter is also termed as anti-imaging filter, used to produce a smooth analog signal that has to be represented at a receiver. So this is the information about PCM coding and decoding. Right. In the next session, we'll discuss about this PCM coding and decoding information along with the data.